pale. Okay. Hold on, let me pull something out of this ass. This is for Fantasia. I promise you this is what I would do. Say in this thing, we didn't have some good times on the other thing. Got me crying on the line. Okay, so I'm back with the Sham's Corner. This is my first time recording from my apartment. You know, I've been doing some big things right now. I'm not at the top where I'm working on it. Taylor's not here right now, so this will be a Sham's Corner without her. But I know I've been going for a minute, like I said, with the moving and everything else. It's been a minute. But y'all know I love some Fantasia. From the baby mama to Free Yourself to Truth Is, whatever it is, y'all know I love me some Fantasia. And so to hear the stories about Fantasia trying to commit suicide, it wouldn't be right if I didn't comment on it. Okay? So I did a little research. I've been following the whole cook thing. Fantasia, you my girl and all. I never would have got that man name tattooed on my body like that. Okay, Fantasia sticking to her story that, you know, she didn't know the man was married at the time. And it very well could be that she did not know the man was married at the time. Because, hey, most of these men out here, they take their ring off, they leave it in the car when they go to work. Just keeping it real. That's how it goes. So, with that being said, Tasia could have very well have not known that the guy was actually married. You know what I'm saying? She could have not have known very easily. But these allegations of her trying to commit suicide, I just can't believe it. I cannot and I won't believe it. And I just read, you know, it says what happened was Tasia took some sleeping pills and some aspirin, some ibuprofen or whatever. Now, she took this, the thing said that she took this after finding out that the lady is suing her for breaking up her marriage. And I look at it like this here. Because of North Carolina, where she's from, and because that's the state where the guy is from, you know, they have some kind of law where you can sue the mistress, quote unquote, mistress, whatever, for breaking up your home, your marriage. So I look at it this way. If Fantasia wasn't American Idol season 3, you know, winner, if she didn't have the millions, if she didn't have the two homes that did not get foreclosed from the rumors, you know what I'm saying? If Tasia didn't have the million, if Fantasia was not Fantasia, would she be suing that woman? You know what I'm saying? Would say he went and got hurt him, you know, he went and got himself some average Joe living from the low ends of North Carolina on welfare, whatever it may be. Not saying that there's wrong with that, because it has its limitations to that. But he went and got him some just average sister that had nothing, or whatever his style might have been, that didn't have nothing to her name. Would she still sue her? But because Fantasia is Fantasia, Fantasia got money in the bank, she want to get her some. Can you doubt her? Can you blame her? I mean, I personally think it's a little low, but I mean, hey, ladies, y'all need to think it's smart. Okay, say Fantasia did break up your home. Okay, that kind of falls back to, you know, you got to remember the way you get these men or the way you lose them. So did you break up, you know, somebody else's home for him? You know what I'm saying? Really, how? I'm not understanding it. But to the suicide allegations, it said that she took these after finding out that the lady was suing her. You got a woman trying to sue you for your money. I would be a little stressed too. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be able to sleep on that. How you gonna try to take mine? You didn't get out there and sing on stage. You know what I'm saying? You haven't done anything that I've done to get that money. You know what I'm saying? And then now, just because of my name and who I am, you want to sue me because your man doesn't want you? You want to try to get my money, my hard-earned money, for you? I would be a little sleepless on that too. So I'm going to say, and I'm going to believe, that Fantasia couldn't get no sleep. Her head was pounding. She had a migraine. And instead of taking maybe 2 or 3 aspirin and 1 sleeping pill, or just 4 aspirin or ibuprofen, that she might have took, you know, she might have took her 3 or 4 ibuprofen and maybe 3 sleeping pills. And she got dehydrated and almost overdosed on it. That's the story I'm going to tell, and that's the story I'm going to stick to. I just don't believe I don't believe Fantasia would actually try to kill herself over that. You know what I'm saying? Okay, pay the trick off. If she wanted, if he's worth it. Now, me personally, I might tell you can have your man and whatever else you want to go, because there's no proof that that she actually did it. Now, I also read that the lady has word that she has some kind of sex tape of Fantasia and this guy named Cook. That's all I know. He's a nobody. I didn't care enough to, you know, look up who this guy is. I don't know if he's an average Joe or whatever he is, but his name is Cook, and you know, Fantasia got it tattooed like right over her heart or something like that. Like I said, pound, stupid move. But that also falls back to, you can't help who you fall in love with, who you talk to, who you do whatever you do with. But that was the whole purpose behind this video. No, I do not think Fantasia tried to kill herself. Yes, I do think Fantasia got a little worried, thinking, okay, what if this woman have some kind of, you know, thing? What if she got some way to prove that I actually broke up her marriage, her home, and she tried to sue me for a little paper? Fantasia, stop tripping, baby. You know you got some dough. Pay off a little bit, chunk of something. Like I said, it depends on what it's worth. If he worth it to just go on and pay her off, you know, have her sitting right for a few years or whatever, because the way she acting, the way the lady is acting, what's going to happen is Fantasia is going to pay her, and she's going to blow that money because she ain't never had anything. That's how it is. If you tripping this hard over a man, and yes, you have kids by him, okay, well, duh, he's supposed to get it in with Fantasia. Hit him up for child support. Use your head, ladies. Use your head. Okay, yeah, boo, you want Fantasia, you go right ahead. I got 4 kids for you. I pushed them all out for you. So I'm going to need child support for every last one of them. All this unnecessary stuff, suing for the marriage and the break. Had a marriage. You can get married more than one time. But them kids, they stuck with you for life. Y'all see, they don't be thinking like that. More people need to think like me. But like I said, I don't think Fantasia tried to commit suicide. That's what it is, and that's what the newspapers are reporting. She needed a drink. Instead of going out and getting a drink, she took her some sleeping pills and a few ibuprofen to get rid of her headache. Fantasia, you should have just sent some up, threw some back, you know, called a few housewives, and they would have helped you out. But until next time, y'all, that's it on that story. I'm going to continue to support Tasia. Y'all go out, her new single, Bittersweet, that is my jam. You know what I'm saying? That is what's up. Don't act brand new on Tasia right now. What would you do if you had money and you had another woman trying to get it? Because she was slipping. You know what I'm saying? So till next time, y'all, it's been the Diva. I'm out.